So why do we want to use quotes? Well, they add life and they add authority to your story. The story is about the newsmaker, it's about your source. It's not about you. So you want to use their words rather than yours whenever you can. Always attribute quotes. Tell us who's speaking. Part of the value of a quote is who was it who said it. You can rearrange the order of quotes for a long interview, but the important thing is that you don't change the meaning of what was said and don't take parts of quotes out of context. Let's talk about the Q&A format. A Q&A is a way of presenting an interview where you have a list of questions followed by the answers that the interviewee gave. Don't present an interview as a Q&A unless you've been specifically asked for that kind of format. What you should do is write a feature and quote from the interview within that feature. Q&As look very easy. It's a very obvious, simple kind of format. They look easy to write. They're actually very easy to write badly. If you write a feature, you have a lot more control over the structure, a lot more control over how the feature works, and what you get is a more interesting and readable result. There are several different ways of using what a newsmaker has told you in your article. The first is to use a long, direct quote. This is best where the newsmaker, the interviewee, has said something in a clear, focused, succinct kind of way. And there's an example there. If the newsmaker has rambled on a bit, and a lot of people do when they talk, one thing you can do is to use a partial quote. So that emphasises one small part of what the interviewee said and strips out the stuff that is too rambling to use. Partial quotes can be useful if a newsmaker's words are long-winded or complex, but they can be confusing if you overuse partial quotes in an article. If a newsmaker's words are long and rambling, don't quote them at all. Instead, summarise what they say in your own words. This is called reported speech. The different methods of handling an interviewee's words can be blended together in the same article. And this is a good idea. It means that you can handle each quote in the way that's best for that quote, and it also adds a bit of variety into your article. Here's an example of a real story that does exactly that. If you attribute quotes using said every time, that can get monotonous. Now that tempts people to use alternatives like replied or commented, but you should only use those when they add value for the reader. So use them when they tell us something else about what the interviewee was saying. Another one people like to use is added, but you have to make sure you only use added for the second time that they say something. A common mistake people make is to use quoted. So they say somebody quoted something. Well, to quote means to use someone else's words. So if someone's just talking to you, you can't use the word quoted. In summary then, quotes from newsmakers add authority and impact, so use them wherever you can. Don't use a Q&A format unless you're specifically asked to. It looks like it's an easy format to put together, but it's best avoided. Use long quotes, partial quotes, or reported speech, depending on the clarity and brevity of the newsmaker's words, and don't overuse alternatives to said when you're attributing quotes.